Pasteurize, or Pasteurize, was a web challenge from the Google CTF 2020. In the end, 260 teams solved it. It was also labeled as easy. This doesn't look secure. I wouldn't put even the littlest secret in here. My source tells me that third parties might have implanted it with their little treats already. Can you prove me right? And we get the link to the challenge website. So, let me tell you how we solved it. The CTF started around 2 a.m. German time, so I didn't play from the start. In the morning, when I got up, somebody else from our CTF team, Alice, already found the vulnerability but hadn't fully solved it yet. Here you can see our internal organizational system. We used to have CTF pad and extended it with some additional features, but some crazy people, I think mainly Cherry Worm from our team, basically wrote this from scratch. It's awesome. You can create tasks for each challenge and people can assign themselves to it. When you click on a challenge like Pasteurize, you get a shared notepad. It supports Markdown and you can look at it with a split view. It's crazy. Anyway, when I woke up, I already saw this. Body parser URL encoded with extended true in /source, which means JSON objects can be supplied, which leads to breaking the JavaScript string. And this payload here, content, and in brackets we have dash alert dash equal dash one dash. Of course, I have no clue what that means yet. I obviously need to look at the challenge myself first. So here we go. We can create a new paste, blah blah, and maybe we can already add some cross-site scripting tests, a basic HTML h1 tag, and a script tag with alert. Huh, we get a headline test HTML, but no alert pop-up. If we inspect the HTML element here, we can see that we were able to inject the h1 HTML code, thus format this headline, but our script tag is gone. So it looks like some sanitization is happening to the text, only allowing harmless HTML. If we look at the HTML source code of this page, so not the currently rendered HTML, but the raw HTML before the browser executed any JavaScript, we can see that the node is actually empty when we load the page. But further down, we can find JavaScript that seems to contain our text, blah, blah, and so forth, also still containing the script tags with alert. Then this node text is passed into the domPurifySanitize function, and then once sanitized, it is added into the inner HTML of our node tag. domPurify is a JavaScript library that performs client-side output sanitization, and I know this library. It's basically the best library you can get if you need to allow some HTML tags, but save from XSS. That's very hard to do, and for many it's unintuitive, but it's actually better to do the sanitization in the browser on the client and not on the backend. I also personally know the maintainer very well, and I know domPurify has rarely vulnerabilities and bypasses, mostly weird edge cases. So I consider this usage here to be completely safe. I strongly believe the goal is not to bypass the sanitization check. Also, we can find here a comment, fix the bug number 1337 in /source that could lead to XSS. So we are not only told that the goal is to find the XSS, but that the bug is not here, but in /source. And when we go to that site, we find the source code of the server. It's written in Node.js. Okay, one other important detail is this share with TJ Mike button. When you press it, you get a message that TJ Mike will soon look at this paste. This is a typical XSS challenge setup. XSS means you attack another user, right? So you need some kind of bot that visits the page and executes the XSS so you can actually pull off an attack. So by clicking this, we trigger the bot to look at our paste. And if we have XSS here, we can XSS the spot and somehow steal the flag. We just don't know yet how. With web challenges, it also makes sense to use a web proxy like Burp to look at the traffic. I'm using here the free community edition, and it also has this awesome new feature with the embedded Chrome browser. It's my new favorite thing, makes the setup so much easier. If we create a paste again, we see here this post request being sent, and looking at the post data, we can find a content variable. This looks oddly familiar, right? In the notes, we also had content. So let's send this request to the repeater and take the example snippet from the notes and modify the request. Send it, and now we created a new node. Here's the node ID. Copy it into the browser, and boom, we get the XSS alert. So how did this work? Let's look into the page source and look at the JavaScript. This looks weird now. Start quote, end quote, so that's an empty string, and then we subtract this alert, and to calculate the subtraction, we first need to know the return value of alert, so we have to execute alert. Boom, triggered XSS. Very briefly, what happened? This payload looks a bit weird because it's already doing XSS, but if we clean that up with a simple key and value and look at the JavaScript code this produces, we can see here the key colon value. Now only look at this part and imagine the first and last quote wasn't there. This is basically a JSON key value pair. The problem is that the key and the value use quotes, and if we simply embed this without escaping those quotes into another string, then the first quote terminates the string and then our key is raw JavaScript. If we look into the console, we can also find a syntax error, unexpected identifier. This is not valid JavaScript anymore, right? But with the trick as seen in the payload, we can make a mathematical expression out of it where we combine these strings with these identifiers through subtractions. A plus or other operations would have worked equally well. Let's also have a peek into the Node.js server code to see why this happens. In the route handler for displaying a node, we can see that it takes the node's content and calls escape string on it. This is important because the node is embedded into the JavaScript on the page. We must escape double quotes so you can't break out. Also, closing script tags have to be escaped, and escape string uses a neat trick to do that. It calls JSON stringify on it. If you pass a string into the function, it will escape the string to go into a JSON string, and that is safe for JavaScript. Only one caveat, if we place that into an HTML document, we also need to make sure we don't get a closing script tag because that would break this too. So the output for this context also has to escape the angle brackets, which is done here. That's perfect. As mentioned earlier, I didn't find this XSS. Locknob found it first. So I quickly asked how. And he said he saw the URL encoded middleware set to extended and he Googled what that means. Then you can quickly find the documentation for body parser, which says that this enables extended syntax allowing rich objects. And for more information, please see the QS library. And here we find QS allows you to create nested objects within your query string by surrounding the name of subkeys with square brackets. He simply tried this out, like our key value example, and saw that it breaks out of the JavaScript string allowing XSS. So you don't really need to understand the server code much, or why exactly the XSS happens, despite the escape string. You can find it just by a bit of experimenting or researching the code. But for completeness sake, the issue is that with this syntax you can create rich objects. The server expected that content is a string, but now content can be an object. And my key value example would result in this string after JSON stringify. And suddenly the string contains double quotes, breaking out of the JavaScript string. Anyway, we have the XSS now, how can we solve it? That was actually the hard part. We had no clue where the flag was. Check out the notes I've written when I tried to solve it. First guess was that we should leak the whole HTML code TJ Mike sees. But I don't see anything in here, full output below. Here's the whole code I had leaked, it also contains how I did that. I simply called fetch to create an HTTP request to a domain. I can see the request and I added the HTML code in base64 encoded form. Anyway, this didn't give us the flag. The challenge description read, third parties might have implanted it. What could that mean, implanted? So I thought maybe another attacker XSS TJ Mike and implanted installed service workers. So here's my XSS payload to look for all registered service workers, but there was nothing. Another guess, implanted, could also mean like embedded in an iframe. Maybe the page we XSS is an iframe. So let's see what the top URL is. Maybe that leaks something. But nope, nothing. God damn, next guess. The challenge is called pasteurize, copy and paste. Maybe we need to steal the clipboard of the user. Here you can see a call to navigator clipboard read text. But nope, no luck. Maybe we should install a service worker to perform man in the middle and capture something else. But as far as I know, I would need a clean JS script hosted on the same domain and we don't have that. And then the last guess I had was with TJ Mike because it had this microphone. Maybe we need to record the mic for a bit and send it over. But I didn't try that, I was too lazy to implement that. My gosh, this cost so much time. In the end, I desperately tried something else. During the CTF, I used Burp Collaborator from Burp Professional, but you can also use one of those many request bin websites. Create a bin, anything sent to this URL will show up here. So we can now craft the XSS payload with fetch to perform a get request to this URL. And I added to it the document cookie. I create this paste, copy the ID, here's the paste, and now we can share it with TJ Mike. And when TJ Mike looks at this post, he should execute this XSS and send his cookie to this URL. If we refresh now the request bin, we can see we got a request from a 104 IP, and I know that this is Google. So Google server is the origin of this request, and when we scroll down, we find the leaked cookie string, and there's the secret flag. Solved. This was overall a very simple challenge, but there was no hint that the flag is in the cookie. This website doesn't use cookies, as you can see here, so it makes no sense to attempt to steal the cookie from TJ Mike. And the wording of the challenge description led us down a very different rabbit hole. So in the end, I wish they had hinted more at the cookie. Maybe said a cookie with flag would be here so that we know, we need to steal TJ Mike's cookie. Anyway. I also saw that John Hammond did a write-up about this challenge in a different style than my video, so if you didn't understand something, maybe check out his video about it. Also, Ginvael did a full walkthrough of all easy challenges from the Google CTF, so check out his livestream recording as well.